I will show you on the ground. So you start with it on your shoulder like that.
Yeah.
It's like not locked out of the knee. And then as you swing it forward, you let your hand slide down.
Okay.
This one stays gripped on it quite tight.
Yeah.
Not, you know, you don't have to squeeze the life out of it. So as you come through, you're allowing it to slide. So you're allowing the weight to pendulum as you do it. So transferring power from your hamstrings, your buttocks, and your back. It's mostly the posterior that's doing the work,
yeah.
But you're kind of bracing your abs as you do it. But unless you have got quite good mind-muscle connection or do weightlifting or something like that, you'll just get the feel of it rather than knowing what your muscles are doing. So, I don't do this very much, so there are definitely people who hit with sledgehammers better than me. So you get it on your shoulder, because otherwise you're not going to swing it.
What, like that?
Yeah.
And then
you're almost with the bend in your leg, you're bouncing it off your shoulder. Perfect. Well, as with all these, you're not good enough to do it next to my head yet.
Okay.
Really good fun.
And good fun.
Right, we need to give you something that's hard to break.
Okay.
Ah, this will do it. It's less fun when it's hard to break, but you get better practice.
Okay.
Okay. Bend your legs more.
Okay.
And then really. I don't think it's anything special, I've just given it to you to smash it up. I don't think it's a nodule, I don't think it's part of the bed.
Oh, no 3D crocodile.
No. but they are good fun.
Yeah.
But if you do hours and hours and hours of it, it gets less fun.
Yeah, I can already feel it. I'm like, that's enough sledgehammering for today.
Well, they,